SAT prep, non-cal coming at you, and we got a doozy here. If x is greater than 3, which of the following is equivalent to that complex fraction? When we got fractions and fractions, we call those complex fractions. First thing I want to address here is this x is greater than 3. What does that do for me in this problem? Well, that just makes sure that my expression is defined. There's no way that my denominators, the x plus 2 or the x plus 3, can become 0 if all my x values are always greater than 3. So really, that doesn't play a role in the algebra that you're about to do, but they do list that in order to make sure that the expression here is defined. All right, enough of that. Now, on to the real deal here. I gotta get a common denominator within my denominator, meaning I'm gonna need to multiply by each other's denominators in this problem. So I have to multiply the left fraction here by x plus 3 over x plus 3, because that doesn't have an x plus 3, and then I need to multiply the right one by x plus 2 over x plus 2. Boom, love it, fantastic. That's gonna give me a common denominator of x plus 3 over x plus 2 within my denominator. Let's see what that looks like. So now we've got a common denominator of x plus 3 times x plus 2. So I was able to write that all in one numerator there. So let's take another look here a little bit closer. Now I have that 1 times x plus 3 and that 1 times x plus 2. But because we're multiplying by 1, doesn't really matter. I can actually just get rid of those. If they were like a 2 or a 3 or something else, I'd need to distribute it in. So really at this point, I can just go ahead and combine some like terms in that numerator of my denominator of this complex fraction. So I'm going to have 1 divided by, and then I'll have x plus x is 2x plus 3 plus 2 is going to give me 5. My denominator, if we take a look at all of my answers here, so let's zoom back out. If I take a look at my answers, they're all foiled out at this point. They're all distributed out. So I'm going to do that. I'm going to have x times x is x squared, and then x times 2 is 2x, and 3 times x is 3x. 2x plus 3x gives me 5x, and then 3 times 2 is 6. And you might be looking at me like, hey man, I think the answer is A because I see this 2x plus 5 divided by x squared plus 5x plus 6, and you'd be dead wrong, all right? What we need to do is we're actually 1 divided by that. We need to get that reciprocal, whoop, okay, and multiply it by that 1. So let's write that down. I'm going to have x squared plus 5x plus 6 divided by 2x plus 5, because when I'm dividing by a fraction, I can multiply by its reciprocal, and I'm really going to have that 1 right out here. To be 1 times that, but does that really matter if I'm doing 1 times that whole mess? No, it's not going to change anything. So this now is my final answer. The answer is B, and boy, that was awesome. Woo! That was a doozy. I hope you guys loved it. I loved it. America Freedom, Rock and Roll, Costco, Rim Dog, Jenny on the Gram. See you later. Deuces.